Dear students, welcome to the today's chemistry CET, JEE and NEET class. So this is the second class on NEET, JEE and CET. We are discussing some important questions on some basic concepts in chemistry. That is under NEET class. So this is the NEET, JEE or CET class 2 on some basic concepts in chemistry. So in this class we can discuss some important questions. So the first question is the amount of sugar, the amount of sugar C12H22O11 required to prepare. Aqueous solution is A 136.8 gram, B 34.27 gram, C 68.4 gram, D 17.1 gram. So here the amount of sugar C12H22O11 required to prepare 2 liter of its 0.1 molar aqueous solution is, so we have to find mass of solute. What is that mass of solute? Mass of sugar we have to find. No doubt this is the question. This is the question on molarity concept. Molarity is one of the concentration term. Molarity can be defined as number of moles of solute to the volume of solution in liter. So it is molarity can be defined as number of moles of solute divided by volume of solution in liters. Volume of solution in liters. So molarity can be defined as number of moles of solute present in 1 liter of solution. So that is molarity is equal to number of moles of solute divided by volume of solution in liters. So here molarity M is equal to number of moles N divided by volume of solution in terms of liters. And once again molarity is equal to number of moles can be written as number of moles beku andaga mass of solute divided by molecular mass of solute.
n.
n can be written as mass of solute divided by molecular mass of solute. So right here, mass of solute divided by molecular mass of solute divided by volume V. That is equals to m is equal to small m divided by capital M into V. So this is a molecular mass. This capital M is molecular mass. So this M is molarity. Molarity. So then we want amount. Means mass of solute we want. Rearrange. M is equals to molarity. Molarity into molecular mass. Molecular mass into volume in liters. Volume in liters. So then mass of solute is equal to, see here, they are given sucrose. Sucrose, C12H22O11 is the solute. So then, first find molecular mass. Molecular mass. Molecular mass of C12H22O11. Find out molecular mass calculation. So that is 12 into carbon atomic mass 12 plus 22 into hydrogen atomic mass 1 plus 11 into oxygen atomic mass 16. So you will get 342 grams. Calculate maadi molecular mass andre 12 into atomic mass of carbon plus 22 into atomic mass of hydrogen plus 11 into atomic mass of oxygen madadaga 342 baruthe. Ili substitute maadi molarity equals to m by mv, or m is equals to molarity into molecular mass into volume. So 2 liter volume there you want. So that is finally mass of solute is equals to mass of solute m is equals to molarity. In the question they are given 0.1 molar into molecular mass of solute to be calculated 342 into volume of solution. So 2 liters. So then m is equals to 0.1 into 342 into 2 liters. So we can write we'll get 68.4 grams. So here amount of sugar required is 68.4 gram. So this is the question asked in JEE 2019. This is the question asked in JEE 2019. This is a simple question asked on molarity. Next one. Second one. be taken in a have been taken in a container in a container in a container of volume V at temperature temperature 27 degree centigrade in the identical condition in identical conditions full stop. The ratio of the volumes of gases, hydrogen, oxygen, methane would be option A, 8:16:1, option B, 16:8:1, C, 16:1:2, option D, 8:1:2. Okay, see here, equal masses of hydrogen, oxygen and methane have been taken in a container of volume V at temperature 27 degree centigrade in identical conditions. Then the ratio of the volumes of gases, hydrogen, oxygen and methane would be. So here you know very well this is an Avogadro law. Avogadro's law states that at constant temperature and pressure, equal volumes of gases contains equal number of molecules. So that is Avogadro's law states that equal volumes of gases contains equal number of molecules at constant temperature and pressure. So that means volume of gases directly proportional to number of moles. According to Avogadro law, volume of gases directly proportional to the number of moles at constant temperature and pressure. So here, equal masses of hydrogen, oxygen and methane are taken in a container of volume V. See, this is the closed container. This is the closed container of volume V. Let us take hydrogen gas, oxygen gas, and methane gas in equal masses. Say you take 1 gram of hydrogen gas, 1 gram of oxygen gas and 1 gram of methane gas. Totally equal masses of hydrogen, oxygen, methane are taken in a closed vessel of volume capacity V. So then what is the ratio of volumes of gases, hydrogen, oxygen and methane? Volume ratio ಅಂದ್ರೆ masses ತಗೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ, equal masses 1 gram each. 1 gram, 1 gram, 1 gram ಅಂತ ತಗೊಂಡಿದ್ವಿ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಮೀಥೇನ್. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಯಾವ ತರ ಇರುತ್ತೆ? ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ಸ್ ಬೇರೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಟು ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್. ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಟು ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ. ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ NH2, ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಟು ಮಾಸ್, ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ MH2. ಸೊ NH2 ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಟು M ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಈಸ್ 2 gram. ಸೊ M/2. ಸೊ ದೆನ್ NO2 ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಟು ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್. ಸೊ NO2 ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಮಾಸ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್. ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಮಾಸ್, ಸಿ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಇಸ್ 60. ಸೊ O2 ಮೀನ್ಸ್ 32 grams. 32 grams. So then find number of moles of methane. Number of moles of methane is equal to mass of methane divided by molecular mass of methane. Number of moles of methane is equal to mass of methane divided by molecular mass of methane. So then NCH4 is equal to mass of methane divided by molecular mass of methane. Carbon 12 gram. 4 into hydrogen 1, so that is 4, 16 plus 4, 12 plus 4, 12 plus 4, so that is 16 gram. So then number of moles of hydrogen, M/2, number of moles of oxygen, M/32, number of moles of methane, M/36, we calculated number of moles. These number of moles are directly proportional to volume. ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ನಮಗೆ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಬಂದಿದೆ. ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಟು ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ದ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಈಸ್, ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ, ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಈಸ್ W, that is M divided by 2 is to M divided by 16 is to M divided by 32. So this is for volume ratio of H2, O2 and methane. So then the simple ratio is, then the simple ratio is 16:2:1. 16:2:1. So 16:1:2 is the simple ratio of volumes of hydrogen, oxygen and methane. So this is the question asked in 2014 NEET exam. NEET examination. This is the question asked in the NEET examination 2014. Next question. What quantity? What quantity? What quantity of carbon oxide? Carbon oxide. What quantity of carbon oxide will react? Calculations. What quantity of carbon oxide will react with 2.80 gram of hydrogen at NTP? See here, NTP means normal temperature and pressure. So here, what quantity of carbon oxide? So let us write a balanced equation. Let us write one balanced equation. CuO, cuprous oxide, reacting with hydrogen, H2, to form Cu plus H2O. Cu plus H2O. Cu atomic mass, copper atomic mass is 63.5 plus oxygen atomic mass 16. So then 79.5 grams. Okay. 79.5 gram of copper oxide at NTP react with 1 mole of gas. 1 mole of hydrogen gas. 1 mole of hydrogen gas means it occupies 22.4 liter. 1 mole of any gas at STP or NTP occupies 22.4 liter. 22.4 liter. So then what mass of carbon oxide is required to react with 2.80 gram of hydrogen. See here, 79.5 gram of cuprous oxide requires 2 gram of 22.4 liter means 2 into 1, 2 gram of hydrogen. So then, what quantity of copper oxide is required to react with 2.80 gram of so this hydrogen we have to calculate. So take this liter only, 2.80 liter. So 1 mole of hydrogen means 22.4 liter. 79. 0.80 liter of hydrogen. So then find x. X is equals to 79.5 into 2.80 divided by 22.4 liter. So that is 9.9 grams. So 79.5 gram of cuprous oxide react with 22.4 liter of hydrogen. So then, what quantity of cuprous oxide is required to react with 2.80 liter of hydrogen? So that is 9.9 gram. 9.9 gram of the hydrogen, that is cuprous oxide. 9.9 gram of cuprous oxide is required to react with 2.80 liter of hydrogen.